What is in store for us? Terrorism moves its pieces on the international board with an unexpected ally, Hugo Chavez. Sworn enemy of the North American government and defender till death of any anti-capitalist or anti-market ideology showing up on the horizon. In a contradicting relationship with the U.S., Chavez harshly criticizes Bush's government, but at the same time, the U.S. market is his best client for the world's main raw material, oil.
Sepa el pueblo de los Estados Unidos que lamentablemente ni una gota de petróleo les llegará desde Venezuela.
Furthermore, he has accused the United States of planning to kill him, preparing his overthrow, placing spies within the Venezuelan state oil corporation, PDVSA, organizing an invasion to Venezuela and terrorizing the world.
Están matando al mundo, y el asesino se llama el gobierno de los Estados Unidos.
The rhetoric helps him unite people and distract the diverse coalition of followers, with an added benefit, winning the sympathy of the international left.
Creo que Chávez hoy
es un presidente
que a cada 10 palabras que dice, dice integración.
Yo agradezco la solidaridad de tanta gente en el mundo ante los atropellos de Norteamérica, del gobierno de los Estados Unidos.
If the United States turn a blind eye, Chávez seems to have won. If, to the contrary, they overact, Chávez will have proven his point. It seems that the attack to the United States is a low-risk, high-yield policy.
Vayamos preparándonos para la guerra asimétrica.
According to estimates, Venezuela provides close to 14% of the U.S. oil consumption. This fact has made the Venezuelan head of state believe that he has the authority to threaten the world's leading superpower with cutting off crude oil supplies.
Olvídense, si se meten aquí en Venezuela los gringos, olvídense del petróleo venezolano.
Due to Chavez's huge control on PDVSA, the Venezuelan state oil corporation, with sales estimated in $84 trillion in 2005, he has been exercising geopolitics in which the crude oil and gasoline price, together with easy terms of payment and barter, have been perversely used to buy support in favor of his expansionist political project.
Hemos comprado unos bonos en Argentina por $500 millones. Hemos destinado de ese fondo sur $30 millones de donación ya. Tan pronto Evo asuma el gobierno, eso está disponible. $30 millones.
Una pregunta, ¿es mensual eso?
A Cuba le habíamos venido suministrando una cantidad de barriles diarios, 53.000.
Una opinión.
Una opinión.
No debemos decir al imperialismo cuánto están suministrando, pero no le vamos a decir nada. Hemos estado recibiendo lo suficiente.
Venezuela is the fifth worldwide in proven oil reserves. Oil geopolitics applied by Chavez's government has been the most effective weapon to obtain advantages such as avoiding the application of the Democratic Charter by the Organization of American States. The Venezuelan opposition has struggled against this regime and its constant arbitrary actions. In 2002, Venezuelans lived one of the most critical moments of their history when they took part in a multitudinous demonstration. What happened that day is still a mystery. Some speak of a military coup. Others consider it a Chavez-organized game to identify his lukewarm supporters. However, the Supreme Court sentenced that there was a power vacuum. All democratic means have been attempted, including the figure of the presidential recall referendum provided for in the Constitution.
Aquí no vendrá OEA ni nadie.
The regime has placed every possible obstacle in the opposition's path. The government is still working to fraudulently provide thousands of foreigners with Venezuelan citizenship and also artificially increasing the registered voters. Which were 10,991,482 in 1998 and 14,301,524 in 2005. Revealing an exaggerated increase of 30% during the almost 7 years of government.
¿Cómo se puede explicar que de la noche a la mañana ese registro electoral haya pegado un brinco a más de 14 millones de electores? Las estadísticas, las variables que se venían estudiando no concuerdan con el registro que acaba de anunciar el Consejo Nacional Electoral.
El mejor sistema electoral que hay en el continente americano es el sistema electoral de Venezuela.
The president brags about ruling only for a group of Venezuelans, from whom he demands absolute and unconditional loyalty in return for presents and small privileges he grants them. He is not president of all Venezuelans, but only of those who are loyal to him. The infamous Tascón and My Santa List are two of the many instruments the regime has used to identify, discriminate, and persecute those who do not submit to its plans. These harmful electronic lists include all those who sign requesting a recall referendum against Chavez, and they are used by the public agencies to intimidate government opponents. They deny them work, identity documents, credits, etc.
Los que ya han firmado están votando.
Ningún funcionario está siendo despedido en la Administración Pública Nacional por razones de discriminación en relación a su participación o a su pensamiento político.
Es que aquí hay personas que los votaron simplemente porque firmaron.
Quienes firmaban estábamos destituidos. Pues yo firmé y estoy destituida.
In the meantime, hundreds of thousands of Venezuelans implore the international community for help and recognition, but are not heard.